if you didn't do anything wrong, I don't think that's how you behave.
No. I don't know what he hoped to gain for that. It was funny to me because I don't know who had the best performance, Jesse Smollett with Robin Roberts or R. Kelly with Gayle King.
Let's compare. Who do you think was more believable?
I believe more people believed Jesse until those two Nigerian dudes showed up. And those Nigerian dudes told fast, didn't they? They didn't wait at all. The police came. Let me tell you what happened. They told right away. They told faster than Michael Cohen. They wasn't playing at all. They snitched faster than Tekashi 6ix9ine. They weren't playing. What? I'm not getting deported for this dude. It's not happening. Jesse Smollett, I believe, told a lie. I think that R. Kelly and Michael Jackson are both, even if you don't believe they did it, let's err on this side. Even if you don't believe either of them are pedophiles, they're both horrible babysitters. We can both agree with that, right? I won't stop listening to your music, but I ain't dropping my kids off at your daycare center.
Should you stop listening to the music if convicted?
No.
Not even if convicted.
People asking black
messing people, with underage kids.
People asking black people, why? How could you sing R. Kelly and Michael Jackson songs after all the horrible things they did? The same way I could sing the national anthem. That's the same way I could sing the national anthem. Because they did horrible. Like when I grew up, if there was mold on the bread, and probably you too, you couldn't throw all that bread away. No. You scraped that part off and you ate the rest. I think people are like that. There are memories connected to those artists. I got married to those artists.
The music is more than the man.
The music is more than the art. Right. Like it's like, so there are connections that I've made. A lot of that music is the soundtrack of many people's lives, so I can understand that.